Okay, I'm going to show you the things that I use when I do smoking and grilling. First, you need yourself a grill or a smoker. You don't have to have a smoker. You can just get a grill and, you know, use one in little pans and put your wood chips in the pans. This is the Oklahoma Joe's Longhorn Smoker that we got a couple years ago. I got a video up. It's awesome. I love it. I'm glad I got it. This here is a chimney for starting coals. I really like that. It's been a lifesaver. You need a good wire brush for cleaning your grates. Here's some of the other things that I use. This here is a bratwurst, sausage, and jerky smoker that I made. If you look at my bratwurst video, you can see how to make that. A good grill mitt. Here is a vegetable grilling pan. I really like that. This one is a Teflon grill pan. Now, I've used this one on the smoking fish, smoking mackerel, doing shrimp, vegetables, all kinds of stuff on that. You can see that on a bunch of videos. Here's the matching one to this pan. It's not Teflon coated either, but I've used it several times. I really like those, so that's something you can get. A good wireless thermometer when you're cooking like a pork shoulder or a roast or something like that. A good meat tenderizer. You've seen that on several videos. A couple of thermometers. One goes to 550, one goes to 220. I think it's raining these things from the trees. Cast iron skillets. I've used this on a bunch of grilling videos. I've used this for with seasonings and all kinds of stuff. It's a little 4-inch cast iron skillet. Here's a little 6-inch cast iron skillet. This, I think, might be an 8. This here's a Dutch oven pan. Now, you've seen me use that, or deep cast iron skillet. It's whatever you want to call it. I've used this on a ton of videos, including my chicken biryani and all kinds of deep frying. It comes with a lid. It's absolutely wonderful. I'll put the links to all this stuff down in the description. This we've used on a couple of videos. This is I did my tacos al pastor on the grill. We've used that. I've used this cast iron cornbread maker on a couple of videos. I've used the wok on the grill, and here's a couple injectors that we've used. I've used that wok several times on the grill. A beer can chicken. I did beer can chicken. Got that video up. This is a hot dog skewer that we used on a fire pit. That's on a video. You can never have enough different types of little skewers. This for cleaning up that griddle, or if you have another griddle, or just cleaning your grates. Of course, this is a barbecue mop. You need a nice set of spatula and forks and tongs. These are Kooglans. I really like them. They're heavy duty. I've had them for a little while. Now, I don't use this fish rack. I got that. Instead, I just do my fish on those grill pans. So I haven't used the fish rack yet. And you need a good little bottle for putting sauces or seasonings or stuff on your meats if you like. So there's some of the things that I use when I'm grilling. Now, I just got this Dutch oven, and I got it for the fire pit over there, so it's not seasoned up. So we are going, and here's the thing for the lid. You know how that works. So I'll put the links to all this stuff down in the description, but I'm going to show you how we're going to season that up. We're going to start this fire here, and we're going to put this in the smoker. We're going to coat it with some olive oil, and we're going to season this cast iron Dutch oven up. Now, if you want to see my pizza stone seasoning, I did it the same way. You can check out that video, seasoning a pizza stone. And we use a pizza stone out here on the grill too. And if you haven't seen that video, that's pretty awesome. We do pizzas on this grill right here. So when we come back, we'll show you how to season this Dutch oven. Okay, so we're gonna get our charcoal going to season up this cast iron Dutch oven. Okay, while we're doing our chicken, we're gonna stick our cast iron Dutch oven lid in here and our cast iron pot, our Dutch oven pot. And in about 15 minutes, we're going to season it up with this olive oil. And then I'm gonna let it stay in there for a little while. Coat this cast iron. I got a rag here. Had it sitting in there for about 30 minutes. Getting hot, don't burn yourself. Okay, we're gonna turn this over. It's only been on here for about an hour. Bottom's looking really good. So we're gonna turn that over and let that get heated up and do a little burn in. All right. We're gonna take our chicken inside. We're gonna leave that Dutch oven upside down for about an hour. And then I think it's gonna be ready for next week's recipes. So for Tom's Manly Meals, oh, look at that. That's that New Orleans seasoning, Weber. Oh. I'm Tom Moore. Good luck to you.